Welcome to Art in the 48. Bienvenidos todos. I'm your host, Alberto Rios. Art is for everyone. It's universal. And finding the space that allows you to express yourself can be a turning point in your pursuit. Since 1975, Xico has given Latinx and indigenous artists a place to grow and create.
Xico's mission is to promote culture and heritage of indigenous peoples through the arts. We believe through the power of art that history should be preserved.
We're here with Donna Valdez, Executive Director of Xico Arte y Cultura. Now, Xico's been around for a long time.
We were founded in 1975 by a group of indigenous and Latino artists. They all shared an inspiration to educate the community about Chicano and indigenous culture and heritage. We do it through the arts, through visual arts primarily, and we're still doing it today. We strive every single day to educate the community, to promote new artists, established artists, teach young children how to produce art, teach other individuals how to appreciate art, and express what's going on in our community.
What kind of opportunities do you give them? You have gallery space for artists who are probably already along the way.
We do.
But you have classes as well.
Yes. We have numerous activities. We have underserved youth arts, which we go into Title I schools. We have a mobile art program is what you say yes to the press. It's our mobile printmaking program, and we take those out into the schools. Our target audience is actually tweens and teens, for they're the ones that really need the artwork. They don't have it in their schools. Quite often it's a program that's eliminated, and if we can engage youth of that age, they will usually stick with us and become adult artists for us. It's our way of continuing on with establishing artists.
Talk about your artist-in-residence programs.
We house two artists on an annual basis. They have their own exhibition space. It's a really great opportunity for artists to promote themselves. Many times artists cannot afford studio space. Our space is free to the artists. In exchange, we have the artists teach in several in-house classes and several out in the community classes.
You also deal with professional development, how to make a living as an artist. That's very important. Can you talk a little bit
about that? Yes, we hold workshops. We work in partnership with whether it be the Arizona Commission on the Arts, the City of Phoenix, some private entities, things as simple as copyright laws, photography,
intellectual property is huge,
right,
especially as the internet.
Exactly. Yeah, because many artists have had their images copied offline. So how to watermark appropriately so that you own the rights, so that it's known to everybody you own the rights to this piece. And that's a great benefit to artists because quite often there's nowhere for them to go to learn these.
Now you focused a lot on printmaking. Why printmaking?
The method of printmaking is our main source of art, and
it's an old tradition in both of these cultures.
It's
right?
Strong in Latinx the history,
especially.
Yes, it was used many years ago to get the word out. Posters were created, and when there was a rally, when there was a dance, when there was a community meeting, the community used to produce the prints and put them on telephone poles, on walls, signage, and that's what we're trying to continue. Now it's become a well-collected, rich art form that's taught in the universities, it's shown in the museums and galleries, highly collected. There are many different forms of printmaking. We focus on mono printmaking and mono silk screening. However, there's lithography, there's woodblock, there's etching, many different art forms.
And that's what I wanted to do. Learn and better understand the art of printmaking. We're here with Janet Diaz, who's going to show me something about printmaking. You are artista and community relations manager here at Xico,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
This is a blank.
This is a blank plexiglass, which is typically used to start a monoprint,
okay.
Which a monoprint is one of a kind. So you're about to create one of a kind piece of artwork.
Can I just start? Just start?
You go ahead and start. And you're gonna make an owl, you said?
Mm-hmm. Let's see, this is something my father showed me how to draw.
when I was a little kid. So I'm going to draw this for my granddaughter, Ines.
And then this here is the ink that we use. It's not paint, it's ink. Our goal is to get your design, your monoprint, onto a paper. We're going to be running this through an etching press. And then do you know about a background, what color background you'd like?
Well, I would love to have a blue background, maybe some green.
Now it's time to fill it in.
Okay.
So
work.
Here you go.
All right.
And then put the brown where you want it. All right. And then, perfect. Okay, Alberto, it looks like you're almost close to being done.
All right.
I'm gonna go ahead and get the press ready so we can run it through the press and see what you've created. I'm gonna put this blank piece of paper over it.
All right.
Put this newsprint over it, put the felt down, and then you get to crank it.
All right.
Go ahead.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah, make sure you have a strong grip on it.
All right.
That's good, that's really good.
There's the jump.
Do you feel that?
Yeah, I feel it.
So what you're gonna do now is you wanna pick it from one corner and then pull it up. Ooh. Go ahead, we can pull it up together.
Whoa.
And there it is.
All right.
Good
All
job.
Right. All right, that's excellent.
That's great.
All right, what fun. This is amazing. Probably this speaks for this is why Xico does this, right?
Yes, and then we wanna encourage the younger artists, the younger generation to keep making it, because the older generation needs to start teaching the younger so we can keep going, so this art form doesn't die off.
Another way Xico helps preserve this art form is by taking it to the streets, so to speak.
We have a partnership with Roosevelt Row, and on first Fridays and third Fridays, we do pop-up exhibitions. So the exhibition will begin on a third Friday and run through a first Friday. Typically, we offer 4 to 6 emerging artists space so they can exhibit their artwork. There are 3 containers. One has an interactive activity at all times, whether it be printmaking, spoken word, something that the community can come and engage for free. And we often let local musicians set up in front and perform. It's just a fun gathering space. We want to bring together collaboration of artists and people.
Well, you're going to do that as you move to the Roosevelt Row area,
yes.
Right?
We are relocating and early to mid-spring to First Avenue and Roosevelt Row. We will still have our hot box containers, but we will also have our organization will be located there. In order to enhance our printmaking efforts, our new facility will have a lithography studio as well, because that is an art form that is actually older than mono printing and mono silk screening. It's actually an art form that was done with stones.
Wow.
And There is not one studio in this community, unless you're at the colleges and you are studying for your master's in fine arts.
You're hitting on all cylinders. Yes. This is great.
We're very excited for our new, for our Xico 2.0. We will be here an additional 100 years, since now we're at 45, and to continue to serve our community, to engage emerging artists and promote.
Okay.
Promote cultural heritage through the arts.
Well, we've been joined today by Donna Valdez, Executive Director of Xico Arte y Cultura. Thank you.
Thank you for having me. Okay.